sometimes we have this kind of hysterical attempt to make preaching very fashionable. You know, we have to grow beard or, you know, dress up like this, or do like this, or do like that, and speak like this, because they will like it. And of course, when you sell Bhagavad Gita as a cookbook, probably it's more popular. But, you know, it's a cheating, right? Or you disguise yourself in all kinds of ways. I remember once in Sankirtan, we got this new fashion from America. Because we had lots of legal problems in Germany. So devotees were thinking, let's do it like they do in America. Every devotee had a wig, you know, yeah? That was really a time in America, they were always putting with wigs. So our Sankirtan leader, we had a Sankirtan who was a very eccentric person. So he said, Prabhus, next weekend we all go in a shopping house and buy all wigs. So we just went, you know, yeah.
Somebody know wig?
Huh? Yes. Artificial. Artificial. So, anyway. So you cannot imagine the next Monday, we had also quite some solid Mataji party, Sankirtan. The Matajis were sitting in advance, they could hardly leave the temple. They were laughing so much. Because out of the temple hall emerged a whole crew of 40 brahmacharis with the most foul haircuts. One looked like Elvis Presley and silver. Unbelievable. What a joke it was. You know, we had to wash it and every Sunday feast we had to comb, you know. Put it on again, and it was hot, and you know, and when the wind blows, you know, normal hair goes like this, but the wig goes like this, you know, that's it. So you have to always look in a shopping window, oh! And people look at us like, problem with the hair, isn't it? You know, okay. This whole joke lasted like 1 month and then we all slid in the garbage bag and just went out normally again.